In this video, I will show you how to delete an extra email from your Facebook account if you're unable to do so because Facebook refers you to check your email for the code that is sent to that email. Now, the problem here is the email they might be referring you to is not accessible, or it is the hacker's email that you don't have access to. So therefore, I'm going to walk you through a step-by-step procedure on how you can easily delete an extra email if you have this notification shown. So the method that I'm going to show you is a bit lengthy, so therefore you have to follow the video and be patient to the very end. And also, this method involves you having your Facebook account locked so that you can follow the procedure of unlocking your Facebook account, whereby at the end you'll have an option to delete all additional emails on your account. So to begin with, you're going to open your browser, then go to the search bar and type facebook.com. So under that, you go to the login page, then click login to another account. So from here, you're going to select forgotten password. So then it will take you to the account recovery page. So then from here, you can now enter the mobile number or email address of the account that has this issue. But you can also enter the full name of your Facebook account. And after that, you continue. Now in the next part, after finding your account, they will ask to send a code either to your WhatsApp, or you can click try another way to see other options that are available. Then you can choose one of the options through which you can get the code, then click continue. So for me, I selected an option of sending the code to my WhatsApp number. So if that is the same case, you can then go ahead and copy the code, then paste, and then you continue. So from here, you'll be asked to create a new password, but you're going to skip this step. And after that, instantly, you'll be logged into your Facebook account. So after getting logged in, then you have to go ahead and log out once more. So you click on the three dash menu at the top right corner, then scroll down and select log out. So from here, Facebook is going to send an email to your other email address notifying you of the recent login. So you're going to open your email that you're able to access to, and then you refresh. So after that, you can now open an email that notifies you of the recent login. So under this email, you're going to scroll down, and then you navigate to the section that says, if you didn't do this, please secure your account. So you're going to long press on that secure your account text, and then you copy that URL. After copying the URL, then you go back to your browser and then you open it, and then you paste that URL in the search bar. So after pasting, then you enter. So from here, you'll be given two options. So you select the second one that says this was someone else, and then you'll be taken through a security check. So you click on get started. Then after that, you click on continue. And the next part is for you to create a new password. So from here, you go ahead and create a new password. Then after that, you continue. Now in the next part, you don't have to do anything here. You're just going to close this page, then go back to your email. Facebook will send another email notifying you of someone else accessing your account. So you're going to open that email. And then from there, you scroll down to the bottom, and then you long press on that option that says secure your account now. So you long press on that, and still you copy the URL, and then you go back to your browser, then head onto the search bar, and then you paste that URL there. Then after pasting, you enter, and instantly your Facebook account will be locked. So from here now, you have to go through the process of unlocking your Facebook account. So you click on get started, and then you have to confirm ownership of the account. So you click next. Now the confirmation options are different. Sometimes you'll be asked to provide a copy of your ID or get a code by email. So then you go ahead and select the email address that you have access to, then click on get code. Then after that, you now go ahead and copy the code that is sent to that email, and then you come and paste to this other area that requires the code to be pasted into. So after copying the code, then you go back and paste, and then you can submit. So after that, the next part is for you to secure your login details, and this is where we are most interested into. Then you click next. So you'll be shown the email addresses or phone numbers that are existing on your account. Then you click next. So from there now, you'll have an option to select the email addresses or phone numbers that you'd like to remove. And then after selecting, you click on remove, and there you'll be able to remove those email addresses or phone numbers that you don't want to have on your account. Now, if you have a similar challenge when you're trying to delete the phone number or when you're trying to change your Facebook password and you're asked to check your email, then I'll still upload another video addressing that. So be sure to subscribe, turn on the notification bell, and also do me a favor by sharing this video to others so that it might be helpful to them as well.